worship in this house that has to be brought forth this morning. And let us lift it up now.
He's going to bless us in dance. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Through my bed,
my future, cause of my past. I'm glad you love me through my good and bad.
And then my dad's gonna come, amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Come on, preacher.
Bless. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Mm. There's a sound of worship in this house that has to be brought forth this morning. And let us lift it up now. Flow to you.
Come on, give God another hand for me. In my good, in my bad, in my mess, I turn it into a message.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Now, he won't take that message, turn it into a message too.
Amen.
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 Real talk. God is the only one that can take even what's good and make it all good.
Hallelujah.
Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Bless your name, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Come on, give him another hand for him.
Thank you for inviting us to come.
Thank you. God in hand praise. Glory.
Hallelujah.
Would you please stand to your feet as I introduce the speaker of the hour, as I present to some, but I introduce to all, our very own Dr. Ricky L. Barnett, coming in his own way.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Give God a hand praise.
Let's praise Him for this house.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Let's worship Him.
Hallelujah.
Let's praise Him for this house.
Hallelujah.
All the devil is a liar. I'm going to flow. Give this anointing to the next dimension. Then I'll give you what thus saith the Lord. Some of them will be blessed after this house today. Some of them will be raised up today. Rando Sukuna Bashata.
Peace was upon his shoulder, and by his stripes, he is healed. What we're saying is right now. Right now, Lord, release from the throne of the angels, lead to your voice. Release out of our sight. Release your angels. Release your angels by the head of our soul. Release your glory in that room. Release your fire in this room. Release your fire in this room. Release your fire in this room. Call for your children. Bring up your children once again. I thank and I praise you. I magnify and I glorify you in this house. I said he's worthy. He's worthy to praise us. Satan, the Lord rebukes you. And we bind your works in this house. There's a palaces, panels, and rivers of darkness. We take authority of you in the name of Allah. In the name of Yeshua, Jesus, and I'm not going to take care of us. Hey, we have been raised together to sit together in heavenly places in Christ. And the Father has placed Christ, high above his own power, strong to dominion in every name that is made in this world to come. So we see in heavenly places, and we direct traffic in the spiritual realm. Say, Lord, we bind on that city bound in heaven. Whatever we loose on earth shall be loosed in heaven. And we bind the strong man, the sickness, the disease and infirmity, and we will release the healing virtue in the name of Yeshua. Release the blood of Yeshua, Jesus. In the name of Yeshua, Jesus. Lord, today, hey, this is the beginning for her. She cannot enter into this room, right? Let she lay back in the she can go. And Lord, she believes she can be your son. Fresh wind upon her anointing, fresh fire. Fresh wind, he said, hey, hot out of the cool. Fresh fire, today, Father. Fresh wind, hey, one more, she came in, son. Hey, hey, bring her here to me. Bring her here to me.
We want to know it, Lord.
Oh, so cool now, huh?
We need to know it.
Shake the head of us. You shall go forth. I command every door that they close in your face. In the name of Yeshua. Open. vessel. I speak each day international doors. Hey. In Africa, open up for you. Say, hey, Calabas, somebody. Shall enter the room, riches and war, I shall flee. In the name of Yahshua.
Oh,
blessed name. Lord, show me fire.
You're gonna burn everything on you and around you. He's gonna take you where you've never been before.
Listen, it'll create your purpose. It'll walk you into your destiny. Listen to the instructions. Bless you.
Oh, praise the Lord. I thank you,
Hallelujah.
Father.
Hallelujah!
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 We come to our hands. The power of the lay hands on the sick man. And they shall be made whole. The power to cast out demons. And devils. Inshallah. In your name. Inshallah. And we give you all the glory, all the praise, all the honor that is due to you and only you. And you alone. I thank you. Father, that you will fulfill everything that you have invested in her. Why sure? Jesus' name.
Yeah!
Lord again, praise. We read in the spirit, but we belong right there where I need to be. Bridget, get ready to my lead in. I'm ready. You guys feel the anointing? His presence.
Sword of the Spirit Power Ministries with Bishop Ricky L. Barnett.
Let's give the Lord a hand, praise. Come on. Let's give our international audience a hand, praise. Amen. Today I will be dealing with something the Lord gave me yesterday to give it to you. And we'll be dealing with the book of Revelations. He's been helping me to look more to the end times as we prepare for the end times through the prophets. And he brought back to my remembrance every vision he had given me when I first came into the kingdom was out of the book of Revelations. And I never had read the book before. But all the visions he had given me when he brought me into ministry was out of the book of Revelations. So that I have end time ministry, and I can't get away from it because he has showed me things that I didn't know about. It was in the book of Revelation. He showed me. So we're going to deal with the book of Revelations. Come with me to Revelations. This first chapter. And I'm going to give some background. We're going to build up on, then I'm going to get into the teaching he gave me. Because I might be teaching more out of this book. So I'm laying some foundational things to help the students here. Amen. The book of Revelation. As you know, they were mysteries, 11 mysteries. Jesus revealed one. John, the Apostle John revealed two. And Paul revealed the eight. So, John wrote through the Holy Spirit the book of Revelation. And that word, if you read the revelation of Jesus Christ, which God gave unto him to show to his servant things which must shortly come to pass, and he sent out and signified it by angels unto his servant. See, that word revelation in the Greek is Apokalypse. Okay? Apokalypse. I spell it right in my eyes. Apokalypsis. And it means to unveil or uncover. It implies the lifting up of a curtain so we can see what is uncovered. Amen. It's unveiling. See, when we use it in writing, it means to reveal or make clear. When used of a person, it denotes visible presence. Here in Revelations 1:1, it refers to both the book and person of Christ. Not a revelation altogether of Christ, concerning Christ, but one from him that God gave to him. So what we didn't hear is Christ revealing what the Father gave to him. See, this is the revelation of the revealing by Christ through the apostle to the church that was given to him by the Father. So when you start reading the book of Revelation, you need to know where it comes from. It's been revealed. It's a revelation of Jesus. Yeshua. He revealed it, the Father gave it to him. See, the writer was an apostle, John, as we know, and the place is a possibly, they always say, the Isle of Patmos. Amen. Which was off the west coast of Asia Minor, where John was banished for the word of God and for the testimony of Jesus Christ. The date was around AD 96. Amen? And for the students, I want you to understand as you start studying this book, there have been three principal schools of thought which dealt with this teaching. So you might read different books on Revelation, but there are three different school of thoughts. And you need to know what school of thought the writer is writing from, or you can get confused, okay? The first one is the preterists. They are the one who believe that the prophecies of Revelation have been fulfilled. There's a lot of writers out there that stand from that perspective. One name is Apostle John Edgar. He's a preterist. When you read the writings, you'll see. So you watch the books you're writing, you're reading, because you need to know their position, theological position they're standing on, okay? Then there are the futurists who they believe the book contains a forecast of universal history. Amen? Then there's the electists who stress spiritual elements and do not attempt to dogmatize the meaning of the detail of the mysterious visions. So it's three different ones. And when you read, you need to find out what stance they have. And they write from that particular stance. Like I told you, we all could be theologians. That's our opinion. Amen. Of what the Word of God is. Amen. So you have to develop your own stance as you develop studying the Word of God and the revelation that God gives you.
Amen?
Amen.
Amen?
Amen. So I'm not the question their stance, and I agree to disagree.
Amen?
Amen? So, it's no problem. And you see, this is the only book in the Bible that contains a special promise to obedient readers. Go with me to, let's go to verse 3. I need to know the underline is, blessed is he that readeth, and they that hear the words of this prophecy, and keep those things which are written therein, for the time is at hand. Blessed is he that readeth. There's a blessing in reading this book of Revelation. We've been taught, let's stay away from Revelations. That's too mysterious. Yet the Word of God says, blessed is he that readeth, and they that hear the words of this prophecy. I want you blessed. It's time for us to be blessed.
Amen.
If you go through the Bible, this is the only book. If you read it, you get blessed.
Amen.
It's the only book also, if you mess with it, change it, you won't get cursed.
Watch it, Richard.
amen.
So God is serious about this. Now you're all students. I need you to get blessed. This house needs to be blessed. So you need to start hearing from this book. And you need to start reading this book. Underline, go back and get it. Verse 3 of it says, blessed is he that readeth. And they that hear the words of this prophecy. You just get blessed by reading and just hearing. And you'll get blessed today for me just reading out of this book. There's a blessing to be released to you. Oh my God. Y'all don't know. And we've been, in our culture, it's like the book of Revelation. It's a book, nobody want to deal with the Revelation. Talk about everything, all the books, all the stories. Amen. But they don't want to deal with this book. And this is what the lesson is. You go find another book that says you get blessed by reading it. It's right there. Blessed is he that readeth, and they that hear the words of this prophecy, and keep those things. And keep those things. So the blessing is in reading and hearing and keeping.
There you go, preacher.
What's in this book. So if you want your blessing, get in Revelations. Today, we're going to deal with the reoccurring thought that Christ spoke about the promises of the overcomers. Okay? I want Brad to do reference scriptures. He's going to read those reference scriptures, and we'll go into the meat concerning the overcomers. 1 John 2:13, 4. 4 and 5, try to read, Brad.
First John 2:13. I write unto you, fathers, because ye have known him that is from the beginning. I write unto you, young men, because ye have overcome the wicked one. I write unto you, little children, because you have known the Father. 1 John 4:4. Ye are of God, little children, and have overcome them, because greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. 1 John 5:5. Who is he that overcometh the world, but he that believeth that Jesus is the Son of God?
I can read that over again. Guys, write these reference scriptures down. Reference scriptures.
1 John 2:13. 1 John 2:13. And it reads as follows. I write unto you, fathers, because ye have known him that is from the beginning. I write unto you, young men, because ye have overcome the wicked one. I write unto you, little children.
Stop right there. You see, he hit everybody.
Amen.
Okay? Keep going.
Because ye have known the Father. 1 John 4:4. 1 John 4:4. And it reads as follows. Ye are of God, little children, and have overcome them, because greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world.
Greater is he that's in you than he that is in the world. You have to have that in your spirit.
Amen.
As we go forth in the teaching, say, greater is he,
greater is he
that's in me,
that's in me,
than he,
than he
that's in the world.
That's in the world.
We have to have that in our spirit.
Amen.
And know that we know that greater is he that's in me than he is in the world. In order to accomplish what God has predestined for you to do, you have to have that as a foundation.
Amen.
Because on this journey,
come on, preacher,
to your purpose and destiny, you're going to be challenged and you're going to have some obstacles. And those challenges and those obstacles is for what? For you to overcome.
Thank you.
Oh my God. I'm going to get to the promises
come on, preacher.
Today for the overcomers. For those who overcome the obstacles, the trials and the tribulations and the tests. So he said, I'll promise you a blessing to those who overcome. So that means you won't have to overcome some things. Oh, you don't hear me now. So God, outside of time, looked into time. He sees the past, the present, and the future as now. Before you were born, he already laid out a plan for you. Good God Almighty. And in the plan for you, there is obstacles and trials and tests that you have to overcome. Oh, you don't hear me now. When I was in the military, I had to go through the obstacle course. Come on, somebody. And some of them, you know, has issues. Come on, somebody. Amen. The one thing I tried to get over that high wall. Amen. I wasn't used to climbing up no walls, you know, like 10 feet high. You know, and I had to do it like 2-3 times to the running start, hit that wall and go on up there and grab it and go over it. All other things I had to do, but that one obstacle, getting over that high wall. Come on, somebody, I keep it real with you. That was my challenge. Amen. See, we have some things that we have to overcome.
Come on, preacher.
Oh, man, you don't hear me now. The title he gave me to give you today is, I can do it. Come on, somebody. Tell your neighbor, say, I can do it.
I can do it.
Tell your other neighbor, say, I can do it.
I can do it.
Say, I can do this thing. I can overcome this trial. I can overcome this situation. I can overcome this circumstance. Why? Because the word of God said, greater is he that is in me. Oh, my son. I'm not operating for myself. I'm operating for the great one that is in me. Come on, somebody. See, God will not give you the test unless he know you can overcome the test. So he placed himself inside of you, inside of your spirit, once you accept Christ as your Lord and Savior, to help you over that obstacle, over that situation, over that trial, over that tribulation, over that heartache, over that pain, over that abuse, over that shame. He put himself inside of you. If you learn how to tap into the greater one, it might seem hard to you in the natural, but you have to operate in the supernatural. You is a spirit that has a soul that lives in the body. You learn how to tap into the greater one. He said, don't look at the things that will seem. Oh, that's a hard, that's a high, a high thing. I can't go over that. But look at the things that are unseen. But that thing that are seen is temporal. But the unseen is eternal. So I gotta tap into the greater one. And I gotta see that thing. I might not can do it. But there's a greater one inside of me. I need the strength to go through. He released the inner your power. The inner chance and power. The God Almighty. If I come to a thing, I can't go through. Good God Almighty. The Iscus power. The pushing, pulling power. Come on, somebody. If I need a red sky, I need a miracle. He released the miracle's power. The miracle working power. Because greater is he that is in me than he is in the world. I can do this thing. No matter how it seems to me, no matter how hard it feels, no matter how I feel, I can do it. But there's a greater one inside of me to make me, push me over things, make me go through things I glory. I can do this thing. Oh, I know somebody may be going through a situation, may go on through a circumstance, but I'm here to decree and declare the word of God that you are overcome. There's a greater one inside of you that can do the work. Get out of yourself. Get into him. And let the greater working power inside of you come out. Hallelujah. Change circumstances. Change situation. You speak to that mountain, it has to move. Now to speak to that situation, it got to change. You have God inside of you. The greater one is inside of you. I put the Holy Ghost up in this place. I can do it. Say, I can do it. Oh, yes, I can do it. Jesus said, hallelujah, Revelation 2:7. He said, oh my God, he said, he that has an ear, good God Almighty, touch your ear. I know I got two. Oh Lord, how did my son, but I got two ears. Then let him hear from the Spirit of God. Saith unto the churches, see, we are the church. Time out the fuck. Church, we are the church. We are the temple of the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit dwells within you. You are a walking tabernacle. Hallelujah. But he's speaking to those churches, those groups of the ecclesia. They are being assembled from that particular scripture. And he's saying, to that overcometh what I give. Of the tree of life, which is in the midst of the paradise of God. He said, I'm going to give you some spiritual food. Come on, somebody. So your spirit needs some food. I'm going to give you some spiritual food. But you have to overcome. I promise you some spiritual food. Hallelujah. There's some things you want to do for me. I place in your way. And I allow the devil, my permissive will, to come in upon you, to put things before you, some traps, some hindrance, to test you, to try you. Oh my God, you said, hallelujah, you love me, you said you were in me. Come on, come on, you think I'm not going to test you, I'm not going to try you, I'm not going to let things come to prove that who you are in me. If you don't prove, hallelujah, that you're in me, how you know? If I don't let you do something, hallelujah, how you know you can do it? Get down on my head. So we gotta go through some tests. We gotta go through some trials. We gotta go over some things in order to know we can do this. The first one might be a little easier. The next one might be a little harder. But first we gotta get over the harder, easy things. I know when I was a little boy, I had a bicycle. Yeah, I kept falling down. Hallelujah, my parents put a training wheels on there. So hallelujah, with the little training wheels, I had a three little wheels. I mean, two little wheels on each side of that back wheel. And I'm riding. Oh my God, I got my back little training wheels. Good God Almighty. So I had confidence that I could ride the bike. So at a certain time, my daddy saw me. He knew what he think he could do. So I snatched, good God Almighty, the training wheels off the bike. The first time I get on one, I was depending on training. So I fell down. And I thought, hey, I saw I want this thing here. I need to try this thing again. So I busted myself up. Right there was strong. Got back on that bike and rolled up without the training wheel. Sometimes God allow you. He be right there. Hey, hey, I'm right there with you. I'm about to present you. You can do this by yourself. No, but I'm still. Mister, my daddy was still there. He didn't want me to fall and hurt myself. So he was close away. I couldn't see him. He, I really get hurt. He had to catch me. Come on, somebody. He'll keep you from falling. Say, I can do it. I can do this thing. I feel the Holy Ghost. We're going to give us some spiritual proof. I got to overcome some things. And hallelujah, go to Revelations. Hallelujah. ear that I didn't hear. I ain't got 2 ears. But the Spirit said to the church, to him that overcome when I give of him now. And I will give him a white and in the stone a new name. Oh my God. Which no man knoweth. Saying he that received it. Saying if I overcome the things of this world, he gonna give me a new name.
Preacher.
He gonna change my name. And think about it. You give me a white stone. And inside the stone gonna be my name. I mean, I can't get inside the stone, but I know, only I gonna know the name in stone. Oh my God, that's a revelation. God gonna do something more than that. If I didn't know the name is inside the stone, without me breaking the stone open, hallelujah, and I know that, oh God, he done done something else to me. He gave me a deeper level of revelational knowledge. He gave me some kind of gift of inside of a stone to see my name. I have a supernatural eyesight. Hallelujah. I'm talking about a hidden manner. If you overcome, that the manner in the wilderness, the children of Israel, the Hebrew, the children of Israel, not even not that manner, but they are hidden manner. A manner that he have hidden for those that overcome in this world. I got some manner that's better than that. Now I gave the children of Israel. I got a hidden manner. I got a sweet manner. He is overcome, baby. I release some manner, some substance for you to eat, the God Almighty. Some part to partake of that you never tasted or ever thought of having. I got something for you, baby. But you just overcome that obstacle. Overcome overcome that situation. Cause why? Cause I put myself in you. The greater one will help you. I will release that hidden matter. Good God Almighty. I taste it. And I say, good. Just like I'm assuming, good. Don't somebody else in a hidden matter. I know if Jesus here. Hallelujah. It's good. Hallelujah. Y'all know how it feels. Y'all got something y'all like to look to. It's that good stuff for you. And we all the things come on. You just give that stuff you don't want. But that good stuff, you get it for yourself. When they leave, you bring out the good stuff. God got the good stuff hidden for you. I for nobody but you can overcome. See, I can do this thing.
I can do this thing.
I can do this thing. Get along with him, pray. I'm going to hallelujah. Give you a new name. And the Revelation 2:26 and 10. He that overcometh and keepeth my works until the end. To him will I give power over nations. He said, I give you authority to rule and to reign with me. Oh my God. I don't know what you're saying, but I want to rule and reign with Christ. I want to rule over nations. So whatever will come against me, so whatever situation, whatever circumstance, I'm going to overcome that thing. It might not feel good. I might not understand. I'm not going to question God why me. I say, God, why not me? Understand the revelation that I have to overcome some things, receive the promise. Lord, I know what I want to do. I know I was sent to do. Lord, so do what you have to do. I'm going to do what I have to do, or whatever it is. I'm going to overcome it, Father. Because you know you would put it upon me if I could not bear it. You would put it upon me if I could not go through it. I know you got my back. No matter who in training, who lies on me, who backbite me, God, I'm going through. I'm overcoming. I got to go around it. I'm going around it. I got to go over. I got to go over. I go under. I'm going up. I'm going to go forward. I can do the same. I'm going to pray to one.
is inside of me. The power of the Holy Ghost is inside of me. You better know who's inside of me. I don't have no fear. I walk in power and authority, every demon, every witch, every warlock, every backbiter, every lying devil, every scandalous soothsayer. I take the power in the Holy Ghost. I walk in power. I have no fear. For the Lord is with me. So you have to know this for yourself.
And I will not blot out his name.
at the book of life, and I will confess his name before my Father, before his angels. He said, he that overcometh, he said, he's going to put you in white raiment. And I will not blot out his name. Oh, out of the book. Oh, my. But I will confess his name before my Father. Imagine that Yahshua Jesus concerning your name to the Father before the angels. But you have to overcome these things that's in front of you. He said, he's going to give you a robe of righteousness. That white raiment is a robe of righteousness. When God brought me into the kingdom, when I just came out in the streets, he showed me my end. And I wasn't accepted. I was enclosed in a white robe in heaven. It's hard for me to accept that. I had something on my head. It's hard for me to accept that. Now, it's a robe of righteousness. He's enclosed me with that. A robe of white raiment. But you have to overcome some things. I'm talking to somebody in here. Somebody may be going through something right now. I want to encourage you. You can do it. Say, I can do it.
I can do it.
You can overcome these things, these feelings, emotions, these situations, circumstances. But he that's in you, you can overcome it. In Jesus' name. Couple more, we'll finish up. Revelation 3:12. Him that overcomes will I make a pillar in the temple of my God, and he shall go no more out. And I will write upon him the name of my God and the name of the city of my God, which is New Jerusalem, which cometh down out of heaven from my God. I will write upon him my new name. He will make you a memorial pillar, a pillar in the temple of God in New Jerusalem. So if you overcome here, you're going to be a pillar in the New Jerusalem at the millennium. And now at the end of the age, when heaven comes down to earth, you're going to be a pillar something that something stands upon. My God, foundation. Revelation 3:21, to him that overcomes will I grant to sit, oh my God, with me in my throne, even as I also overcame. And I'm sat down with my Father in his throne. He said he gonna do an enthronement with you. I will grant this. If you overcome the things in this world, things that come against you in me, I will grant you to sit with me in my throne. My God, imagine that. Even as I also overcame, Jesus had to overcome. And I am sat down with my Father. Strong. I need to underline that. These are things that encourage you to overcome the things that you will be confronted with from this day forward. Revelation 21:7. He that overcometh shall inherit all things, not some things. He that overcometh shall inherit all things and will be his God. He shall be my son. He that overcometh shall inherit all things. And I will be his God, and he shall be my son. To inherit all things. So you see, there's benefits in overcoming the things while you're in this body. There's benefits and rewards to overcome everything that confronts you.
Come on, preacher.
It's a benefit, eternal benefits. It's in this word. You guys should have wrote all those scriptures down and study behind me. There's benefits in overcoming. To the crying of blues, overcoming.
Amen. Amen.
If you look back over your life, and I look back on my mind, I have been through a lot of things. If not, I wouldn't be here. So that means that, God, you have already been through some things. You thought you could not make it through. Because you're still here.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. So that means that you are overcoming.
Yeah.
So when the next thing comes, you have to reach back in your remembrance. I went over this. I went over that. So I'm definitely going to go over this Because back then and there he was with me. And right now he's still showing up with me. Because I understand where I am, man. I understand his word better. I have the revelation that he's been working with me all the time. And when I didn't know him, he was with me, now I know him, and I can call on his name and from a relation to a relation. Come on, somebody. So this thing that confronted me, I'm going to overcome this thing and just say next, baby. Bring it on. Because I know him. I got to work this thing to the better meaning. I got to overcome some old obstacles, some old situations, some old circumstances. I gotta jump around some water traps. Come on, somebody. I gotta overcome some old hurts, some old wounds. I can do this thing. Turn to your neighbor and say, I sure enough can do this thing. The God Almighty, before the foundation of the world. Hallelujah. He said, I can do this thing. I come in agreement with heaven and earth that I can do this thing. No matter what I confront with, no matter what situation, what circumstance, there's a greater one that's working inside of me saying, you can do it. You can do it. I'm with you. No, I'm with you. Even to the end of the world, you can do it. You need to say, I can do it. Tell your niggas, I can do it. I don't know what you're going through, but you can do it. God said you can do it. I know you can do it. You got to start believing in yourself and the greater one in you. That thing that confronts you now, the devil be captured. The devil is a liar. You might be found, you better get up. You might be sad, you better turn and happy. You better get a glad, glad, and a happy, happy. The joy of the Lord is your strength. Hallelujah. I can do this thing, baby. I can go through this thing. I can go through the storm. I can speak to the storm. And it must come out of the heart of faith. In the name of Yahshua, Jesus. I can speak to situations. I can speak to circumstances. But I got somebody inside of me. I got to stop working. I got to not lean out to my own understanding. But I got to acknowledge him in all my ways. And he shall direct my path. I can do it. How about you? How about you? I can do it. Whatever confronts me, I can do it. I'm going through. I'm going over. I'm carrying some things around. Heaven suffered violence, but I'm violent. Take it back for us. I'm taking this thing. I'm taking back my joy. I'm taking back my peace. I'm taking back my substance. But I know that a greater one is working inside of me. I can do it in Christ Jesus. Let's give the Lord a hand for you. I can do it. Let's give the Lord another hand. Praise the Lord. Let's give you some music. I'll make sure everybody know Christ.
Preachers.
I'll make sure there's not one in here who don't know Jesus as their Lord and Savior. He said, the day you hear my voice, heart, not your heart. There are ones who don't know him. Come. Surrender. To the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. And that's why I want to rededicate their lives. You might have made a mistake and you fell backwards. You want to be restored. Come. Come, come, come. You can go. Let's go. God knows from a restoring back. But when you act like a restoring back, pray for him. There are one. Pray for him. So you have a call on your life. You can run, but you can't hear. I say you can run. There's a mark upon you.
Take me. The reason why I've said
you can slip. You can slack. You can keep. and you can have. God's still going to preach it. He's right there with you. When you're doing wrong, he's still there. So he got his seal upon you. You can't give him. He loves you. That's why Jesus died for you. He hung on the cross. For the sixth to the ninth hour. He had the power to come off the cross. When he looked down through the hills of time, he saw you. He said, I got a hand here for him. But I love him. I want him to do this work for me. But I want him to be with me.
There you go.
If he come out of this body. God loves you so much. He died for you. He bled and nailed the nails in his hands. Put a crown of thorns on his head. And he's stripping naked, humiliated. Every human in this. They call him everything but the child of God. Do they not? Say amen. He did it for me. Because he wants me. To be with him. In paradise when he comes back. The Lord said, all your sins come out of the blood. So you confess your sins and feel like just in the middle of your sins. You have to be perfect. Come to the house of God. You come here, give this you want your altar. Say, Lord, forgive me. Don't run from one too. Don't run from one too.
Take me higher.
We love you. You're reaching into
the holy place.
Restore me. Spirit.
That's
what I'm
gonna be. Where your mystery is, you are
for me.
I want you to take me beyond the court.
Yeah.